Praise the Lord. This is Dr. Wilbert Mutoko, and I'm so excited that you have tuned in. Today, I'm speaking on a message entitled Changing Your Generational Name. Changing Your Generational Name. Praise the Lord. And I'm taking my reading from the book of John, chapter 1 and verse number 46. John chapter 1, verse 46. Changing your generational name. Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." Praise the Lord. So this is a time when Jesus was beginning to gather his team. He was gathering his disciples. One of the disciples was called Philip, and Philip was now walking with Jesus Christ. And then Philip gets to a point where he meets a gentleman called Nathanael. And he says to Nathanael, "We have found Jesus. We have found him who was written in the book of the law by Moses." And Nathanael responds and he says, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" That's a very profound statement. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? Philip did not want to argue with Nathanael. He only said, "Come and see. Come and see. I don't need to argue with you. I don't need to convince you about this Jesus. Just come and see for yourself that indeed something great has come out of Nazareth." This is very touching. So it means that everybody knew that nothing good can come out of Nazareth. It was well known. It was a byword. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? Nazareth was known to be a poor place. Nazareth was known that there is no celebrity. Nazareth was known that there is nobody who could do anything outstanding from the place called Nazareth. In my own thinking, I'm imagining the place probably was cursed. Probably there was a prince of the air that was sitting there, some demonic, activity, some principality, some power, some spiritual authority that made sure that in Nazareth, nothing big could ever happen. But thank God, a man called Jesus, born in that same place called Nazareth, he broke that curse. He broke the chains. He broke the records. And up to now, Jesus is celebrated more than 2,000 years later. Whoever comes from Nazareth now can be proud that the man called Jesus came and he broke the generational curse. He broke the generational name that was, a byword. You can change your generational name. I'm not talking of you changing your name like my name is Wilbert Mutoko. I'm not saying I should change my name, but I'm saying if my family has been known for failure, if my name has been known, my family has been known for certain kinds of sicknesses, if my family has been known for adulterous activities, if my family has been known for not worshiping God or for doing nasty things, because I have known Jesus, I can decide that I'm changing my generational name to become a great name. Praise the name of Jesus. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? Maybe people are asking, can anything good come out of the Naledi family? Can anything good come out of the whatever family using your surname? Can anything good come out of it? When we were growing up, there are certain families that were known that when you hear the sound of a car, that car cannot be anyone else's car. It can only be that family or that family or that family. Until somebody in your family decides to break the jaws of poverty so that you can now be able to own a vehicle, not to show off, but to make life easy. To change your generational name. to change the way people have laughed at your family. There is somebody who must be willing to pay the price. Jesus paid the price. He fasted 40 days and 40 nights. He was a man of prayer. He would wake up early before dawn to pray. He was a man of dignity. He decided to be a man of integrity. He decided to be a leader that was outstanding. Wherever he appeared, whatever he said, people would ask, what manner of man is this? But this man was from Nazareth. When Nathanael first of all questioned, can anything good come out of Nazareth? You can decide to pay the price. You can decide to improve your life so that the generational name, your surname, will be remembered for something good. There are certain families that are known for robbery. They are not known for anything good. There are certain families that are known for poverty. Even if it rains so well that year, they will still go out there begging. The whole family, everybody is known for begging. Can anything good come out of that family? I'm waiting for that day. If you decide to pay the price today and begin to, you know, get better so that your whole family will arise from that poverty, that your whole family will arise from that life of sin, that your whole family will arise from that byword. You create a new generational name. You become well known for doing well. There are families that are known for suffering year in, year out. Some of you, you find that it's difficult for you to stay with a man or to stay with a woman. When you check properly, you also see your mom had the same problem. Some of you, you check, you see even your grandmother had the same problem. It's a chain. It's following the blood. Until somebody decides to arise and say, enough is enough. Something can happen in my family. Our name can change. We can have a good reputation. And that somebody can be you today. You can make that decision. I'm saying, today is the end of poverty in my family. Today is the end of sin in my family. Today is the end of shame in my family. Today is the end of premature birth in my family. Today is the end of divorces in my family. Today is the end of murders in my family. Today is the end of failure in my family. Today is the end of poverty in my family. Today is the end of adulterous acts in my family. Today is the end of girls giving birth to babies without fathers. Somebody has to make that decision, and that can be you, and it can be today. In the name of Jesus Christ, receive that grace to break every yoke of the devil over your family. Receive that grace to break every yoke of the devil over your family in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You can decide to go back to school, to break that shackle of poverty. You can decide to pray and fast and pray and fast and pray and fast and declare the word over your family, creating a generational name. When you go to doctors, sometimes they ask you, you have high blood pressure. Do you have a history of high blood pressure in your family? Do you have a history of sugar diabetes in your family? Do you have a history of cancer in your family? It's following the bloodline. Somebody has to be angry now and start fighting. You cannot relax. You cannot relax. Tell you what, somebody has to stop this attack of the devil over your family, and that person can be you. Somebody has to stop this harassment that has been on your family for a long time. Somebody has to decide to stop this harassment in the name of Jesus. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? Can anything good come out of Nazareth? Philip says, come and see. From today going forward, I see you taking steps that will cause people to say, come and see. Even yourself, you will tell people, come and see, I have made a difference. If people have not been having white wedding in your family, you can start it. If people have been so poor, if people have been running business, they succeed to a certain level and it crumbles down again. People have been having families. After some time, it crumbles again. And people say, can anything good come out of this family? You can make that difference in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Wilbert Mutoko.